Hello guys, so today I'll be showing you how I was able to pass another 50k account on FundedNext using a bullish setup on CardJPY, and also be doing the trade breakdown to show you how I found my entry. So I did pass the account last week on Thursday, I think. Then the following day on Friday, I got an email with a new funded account login details. So at the moment on FundedNext, I've done 350k accounts and I've passed all of them since the year began. I haven't failed a single account. So if I take you through my dashboard, you will see I do have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 accounts, because that is phase 1 and phase 2 for each account. So here's the first account that I passed, here's the second, phase 1 and phase 2, and here's the last one, which was actually on phase 2 by last week. It was up close to about 2%. Then I got that one set up on CardJPY, which assisted me to hit the 5% target. So if I take you on the trade overview, you'll see that setup, which is actually here. So currently on my FundedNext, I've not failed a single account, and I don't have any account in the challenge phase remaining, because I had 350k and I've passed all of them. So if I take you to my active account, you'll see all of them are currently funded. One of them is in a drawdown of about 3%. I took a trade on the wrong day and also used quite a bad risk. Otherwise, it should only be down about 1%. But I mean, that's part of trading. Sometimes you make mistakes and you just have to keep going. So on this account alone, since it was funded, I've done about 4 payouts in a period of, I think, 3.5 months. On this second account here, which was the second to get funded, I've done only 1 payout. Then here we do have the latest account, which I've not taken any single trade yet. Also on this account, which was the first to get funded, I'm really aiming to have it scaled up. So on the FundedNext website, you will see they have a condition for you to scale up your account, and here's what you need. So within a 4-month period on your funded account, you need to achieve a minimum accumulated growth of about 10%. Currently on this account, if I take you to my trading overview, you will see the curve is not smooth, because every time I make profit and I do a payout, the graph comes all the way back down. So if you see the graph coming back down, that is not necessarily a drawdown, that is actually withdrawals most of the time, especially the ones that are coming back to the 50k starting balance. So as you can see, at some point I had a profit of about 5%, which I came and withdrew all of it. I also had a profit here of about 2 point something percent, I withdrew it, and I had another one here. So I've had 4 profits on this account. I don't know why the graph is showing 3 alone, but I've had 4 withdrawals on this account, and accumulatively the growth has surpassed 10% within this period. So I've already hit that condition. The second condition is that you should do at least 2 payouts within the 4 months. I've done 4 payouts on that account. And the last condition is that your last trading cycle should end in profit. So for me, currently I'm 1 trading cycle away from completing the 4 months of trading this account. And once the cycle is complete, all I need to make sure is that the last cycle, my account closed in profit. They haven't specified the profit, so meaning as long as it closed above the starting balance, I should be eligible to get a scale up of about 40%. So assuming you do the 40% increase on a 50k account, that's about $20,000, meaning the account balance will have been scaled up to $70,000. So that's what I'm currently aiming for this account. So I haven't been trading it much, because I've already achieved all conditions to scale up, and I don't want to mess it up right now when I'm just 1 cycle away. It's still very possible that the cycle could end and I finish in a loss, which would be quite unfortunate, and you'll just have to keep trading again until your next cycle. But anyway, I'm just showing you that to give you some insight that if you're a good trader and you get a good farm which is not having issues, and you're able to manage your account consistently, not only do you get funded, not only do you do payouts on that account, but you also get the chance to scale up the account over time. Trading profitably for a 4-month period is not very easy for many people. That's why it's important to focus on getting the skill, so that when you get your funded account, you can make the most out of it. So that's it. My funding on this platform alone is sitting on $150,000, and now I'll be taking you to show you the trade breakdown. But first, let me share with you this amazing platform, fastbull.com, which has different tools you need as a trader, including an economic calendar that shows you the different fundamental activities happening in the market. And this time I also want to show you something they have on their website, which is the contest. So if you come and click on the contest here, it will bring you to a page where you can register and participate in their trading contest, which is basically just trading a demo account that they'll provide. Then the winners get some cash prizes. So as you can see, this is the prize for the first person, second, and the third person. And if you're wondering how you participate, come and click on the rules here. You'll get a detailed explanation on when the contest begins and ends, and what you need to participate, and how you need to trade, and all those terms and conditions. And the prizes are awarded to the top 10 participants. So be sure to check that out, and not to forget that you can also come on their website and check under the news. You can check under the analysis, and you can find analysis from institutions. So you want to be aware with what is going on in the markets. Like today, we just had the release of PPI a few hours ago. And if you come here, you'll find articles that give you further details about these fundamental activities. So as a trader, you want to make sure you're also very updated with this. Finally, they also offer the trading charts where you can come and do your analysis. You can customize your template to set the market however you want it to look. There are different tools on the left panel to assist you whenever you are trying to analyze the market. Also, the candles are not limited, so you can scroll as far as the market existed without having a limitation on your candles. And all this is free forever, so you won't be charged for using their platform. That being said, let's get back into the video. So I'll use the chart replay to show you perspective of what I was seeing in the market last week on Thursday when I executed the buy setup. First things first, we go to the daily time frame, and as you can see, CAD/JPY has been on a long-term bullish trend. However, in the last about 3 to 4 weeks, it's been dropping with a lot of momentum. In the recent weeks, we also had Japan hiking their interest rates, which really catalyzed this drop. However, for me, I'm not usually focused so much on fundamentals. I just try to remain with my technicals as long as I'm focusing on key levels in the market. And also, the reason why I don't factor in fundamentals a lot is because I'm a day trader and I look for very short-term setups. A typical setup on JPY, which is supposed to hit about 45 pips, usually hits within the same day. So realistically speaking, over the long period of time, news usually doesn't affect my market so much. The only thing I do is to make sure I avoid trading specific days when we have high impact news like CPI, interest rates, and PPI. Apart from that, my trading is not so much based on fundamentals at the moment. Now, if you come back here, you can see Thursday is when I was looking for my setup here. So I start by monitoring what happened in the previous day, which is Wednesday. Now, CAD/JPY being in a long-term bullish trend, the thing is you wait for the market to come back to key levels, and it's been dropping quite significantly. And one thing you'll notice from a price action perspective, I want you to look at this drop from this point to this point. There is no single day where we've had a bullish candlestick coming to engulf the previous bearish candles. So if you check this drop from the high when the bearish momentum started, these were the first bullish candle, and as you can see, it never had enough momentum to close above any red candle. We also had another bullish here. It never had momentum to overpower the seller. Same thing here. Until somewhere here last week when the market came to this level. And the first thing is, that was a very key level of support that was already existing on my chart. So if I come and zoom out my chart, you will see where I've marked the support. It's a level that has been working over the years with over 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 price touches at the same level. And most of the time, whenever price comes to this level, we see it bouncing back bullish. Now that's exactly what price did here on Monday 5th. Came back to that support and we saw a very long week, which is also a very good sign that sellers have got some significant rejection at this level. And as if that's not enough, we had our first bullish and our second bullish. However, you notice something, as I've shown you, during this whole period, there has not been any significant bullish momentum candle that has actually overpowered any bearish candlestick until here on Wednesday 7th. So if you check on Wednesday 7th, we did have our first significant bullish momentum, and it went and closed above at least this previous bearish candle. So already from a price action point of view, that is enough reason for you to see that buyers are potentially kicking in onto this level in the market. Now, I want you to understand something. It doesn't have to be that this trend is going to reverse and go to become bullish. I'm not telling you that this market is about to continue buying for the next 2 months or 3 months. What I'm just telling you is that there is a high chance we will see some buyers kicking in. And whether they are going to kick in for just 2 or 3 days, that's all we want to take advantage of. Especially considering that the long-term trend has not yet completely reversed, and we still know that overall this market is completely bullish. So that's also another sign of confidence for me. So after seeing this bullish candle, I was convinced that this is a sign that we might see buyers coming in the next day. So the following day, which is on Thursday, the first thing I do confirm is that there is no high impact news in the economy calendar. And as you can see, the specific fundamental activities that I usually watch out for are not there on this day. So again, I had confidence that Thursday will be a good day to be in the market. So going back to the lower time frame, my trading day usually starts at about 6 a.m. That's when I start to actively look for setups based on the backtest that I've done on these pairs and the times that the setups have been performing well according to my data. So from 6 a.m., there are two things I'm looking for. Number one, if the market has already been buying for a long time, by the time 6 a.m. is happening, I can't check a setup unless we do have some significant pullback. However, in the case I come and wake up in the morning and the market has already done a pullback, if I now get an entry confirmation, I'll be taking it. But if I get my market is up there, I won't take an entry unless it does a pullback. And this is just something that you can backtest about the cycles of the market you are trading. Any market you are trading always has cycles, in the sense that after the market has been buying for a while, it will always do some pullbacks, whether it's in a bullish trend or in a bearish trend. Even if you look in in a bearish trend, the market will drop and drop, but at some point there must be a pullback. So whenever you're backtesting, you want to try and also monitor the levels that are good for entry in terms of allowing the market to do the correction before you can take your setup, especially if you are respecting the trend direction. So I'll just play the candles from 6 a.m. and let's see what happened. So usually what I'm looking for is a W pattern before I check my setup. Now if you check carefully, we did have a very significant W pattern here. However, there are a few things that my W pattern usually has to meet before I can use it as a valid entry point. And one of those things is that I usually want my W patterns to be quite small. So anytime my W pattern is too big, I usually avoid it. Now, how do you know if your pattern is too big? Very simple. It depends on your stop loss level. So the whole idea of a W pattern, if I can just explain to you, is that it's a sign that the market is about to potentially reverse from selling to buying. So when you see this pattern, it's simply showing you that sellers have been strong, but now we are seeing buyers trying to reverse the price and go all the way up. So what you need to do is, instead of just taking any W that comes into the market, because not all of them will be high probability patterns for an entry, you need to try and identify, based on the market you are trading, what are the best levels where if I check the pattern there, there'll be more confidence that it's likely to work. That's why you'll see that for me, even apart from the W, I also usually go back and check the previous 1 hour candle, and it must be in favor of the trend direction. Because if the idea is that every time you see a W you'll be buying, then you might see even 10 W's in a day, especially on the lower time frame. So you have to understand that any concept you're applying in the market, you want to combine it with maybe one or two other concepts that will help you to get confidence before you can validate your setup. And it doesn't mean that because it's high probability, it cannot fail. So high probability just means that as long as you keep taking the same setups over time, you do have an edge, meaning your net result will be a positive. So you don't have to be winning all your trades just because it's high probability. So before I lose track, I was explaining to you the concept of a W and why I always want them to be small. So the thing is, whenever you're using a W, your best stop loss point should be somewhere below this low here. Assuming I come and check my buy entry here at the neckline, if I check my trade there and my stop loss is somewhere below this low, I'll be using a stop loss of about 26 pips. While for me, I don't like to use very big stop losses. So my average stop loss is usually about 15 pips, because when I'm aiming 15, it's easy to target 45. That's a 1:3. However, if I start using a stop loss of 26 or 30 pips, it means for me to do a 1:3, I now need to target 30 times 3, which is 90 pips. And remember, the further your take profit is, the less likely you are to achieve that target, depending on the market conditions. So if your W is completely big, there's a high chance your stop losses will be way bigger. So long story short, this W wasn't a good one for me, because the stop loss could have been quite big. So I ignored it and I continued to follow up with the candles to see how they were playing out. Again, the market came and formed a second W. We have a drop, we have a buy, we have a drop, and we have a buy. Same story if you come and check this W, assuming you're going to use this as your entry. Again, stop loss below the low will be literally over 30 pips. So again, I ignored that pattern and I continued with my day. And now at about 2 p.m., the market formed another W pattern. This time it was quite tiny. We have a drop, we have a buy, we have a drop, and we have a buy. Whenever I'm doing my patterns, I only focus on the bodies. I don't use the wicks. Even when I'm measuring the size, I only focus on the bodies. So now you can see the difference between pattern 1. We do have pattern 2 there, and we do have our last pattern, which is 3. Now if you look at this tiny pattern, you can see if I'm going to use this for my entry and my stop loss somewhere below that low of that pattern, you can see it's now about 9 pips. So to me, these are the kind of patterns I always look for, and this is how I always find very precise entries in the market. We did have our W here, meaning I can now come and take my trade whenever the market comes and retests the neckline, which is here in the mid. Normally I use a 15 pip stop loss, but this is where I try to apply my experience in the market, and I shifted my focus to just go with the flow of the market and what price was doing. In the recent days, this market has been very volatile, and a 15 pip move usually gets hit within seconds literally. So during these market conditions, I didn't have the confidence to use a 15 pip stop loss, because just one candle like this, for example, you can already see is worth about 54 pips. So using a 15 pip stop loss wasn't really practical to me in this market. So I decided to shift my stop loss this time to about a 20 pip move. And also by putting the stop loss at 20 pips, it was literally beneath the wick of the previous low, which is a very safe point to put your stop loss. However, because the market conditions are very volatile, the same way I've been able to increase my stop loss is the same way I was able to have the confidence to increase my profit. So if I'm using a 20 pip stop, for me to replicate my same 1:3 risk to reward, I'll have to adjust my profit to 60 pips. That's exactly what I did. I put my entry there with a stop loss of 20 and a profit of 60. Next thing is to wait for the market to come and trigger my entry at the retest. And as you can see, the next candle came and triggered my entry, and it was quite bearish. At this point in time, I was very scared and regretting why I took the setup. And as I mentioned before, by the time I'm taking my entry, I always look for 1 hour time frame confidence. And by the time I was taking my entry here at exactly 3 p.m., the previous candlestick between 2 to 3 had just closed bullish. So I had confidence to believe that this might be a very perfect timing to go long in this market. So you'll be able to see if I play the candle that this market dropped all the way very close to my stop loss. And I had so many reasons to panic and get out of that trade. But as usual, as long as you set your risk management in place and you know the setup you're taking is of high probability, you just need to let the trade run so that the markets can play out. So that was literally it. And within the next one or two candles, I'd hit my take profit. Boom, just like that. The next candle came to my favor and I trade closed with a 1:3. And at this point, I was glad that I didn't use a 15 pip stop loss, because had I used a stop loss of 15 pips, actually, which is my normal stop loss, as you can see, it came and got hit. But the only reason I made money on this trade is because I was able to adapt and see what the markets were doing. And I decided to give my trade more room. Well, at the same time, I was still able to target my 1:3. And that's exactly how I was able to do slightly just over 3% on this trade. I risked just a little bit higher so that in case it goes to my side, it completes my challenge. And also I had the buffer to risk like that because my account was already in positive. So as you can see, it did about 3.something% and ended up passing my phase two. So that's it for the trade breakdown. I hope you've learned something. Personally, my last trading month has been quite slow because JPYs have been doing the opposite with what I've been looking for. And I don't fancy jumping into the markets and just starting to sell quickly because everyone is selling, you know, without having an exact plan, without even being sure that you have an edge within what you are doing. Hence, I've been out of the market for a while. It's been more of monitoring the pairs to just see how they're moving and how they've been reacting to the different fundamental factors. So be sure to drop a like if this video assisted you, and I'll see you next time.